the observance, what we observe. But I would have preferred that you would do that job for me. Because the essence of our coming out today, especially with you, the press, with the MESEC members, with the convener of security, with the convener of environment, with the convener of justice and security, with the convener of trade and industry, it means that the whole assembly is here. We are here with our presiding member. The reason why we came is that you will recall in December, the traders came to our office, as has been done previously, to seek for a place to do their business. In Kumasi, Kumasi is a trading area. So anytime it's getting to Christmas, at least for 3 weeks, we give it to them for them to come out, sell their product. Because looking at the number of traders, the number of buyers that comes into the city during the Christmas festivity, if you allow all of them to move into the inner part of the market, there will be stampede. That is why we always allow. But that has been done previously. By 15th, they are all gone. But this year is exceptional. Today is 1st February, yet they are there. The question somebody will ask is that, have you served them notice? On the 15th, we reminded them. On the 18th, they themselves came to the office. We had a meeting. And they promised that they will go back, have a meeting with their membership, and their membership will move voluntarily. 21st, we engaged them again. Then it necessitated the assembly writing a letter to them with copy to RESEC. But today is the deadline. So we are here to observe whether they've lived by their word of living. So we are here to observe situation, report back to the RESEC, so that when the regional minister also add his weight, we will come back and do the needful.
But with what you have observed so far, are concerned?
No, so with regard to COVID-19 protocol, you observe that on several occasions, we have to prompt people to wear it. We have to prompt people to wear it properly, meaning that the announcement still has to go on. The enforcement needs to go on. One thing is that anybody you call has it. Either he has it in his pocket or he has worn it, but not properly. But if you want to give the aggregate, I would say that more than 70 have done it properly, but the remaining 30 can also create problem. But one thing with COVID is that you can observe the protocol, but if others do not do it, that person can pass it on to you. And therefore, we should be our brother's keeper. We need to enforce it. But this time round, I am counting on you, the press, because we have as many as 50 press houses in the Ashanti region and in Kumasi. So if all of you add your voices to it, then the message will get deeper and deeper into all the people. And I'm sure even what we have done today, the signals is gone. And once the signal is gone, we will see improvement. But this is not going to be the end. This is the beginning of the action.
In previous social distancing, but what we are observing today, are we likely to revisit that particular protocol?
That is the area we are going. Today is fact-finding. The next action is to have a meeting with the leadership of the market. That is why today I'm here with a convener for social services, with a convener for environmental, with a convener for trade and industry. So as soon as we go, the trade and industry, who has the mandate to manage the various markets, will pull out the list of the key managers, invite them for a meeting. Then the Justice and Security Subcommittee will also meet, strategize as to how they will be able to enforce the bylaw. Now, when we came out, there's one thing that is clear. Early this morning, the whole city was clean. But what are you seeing? Messy situations. The direct environmental head is here. So he is also going to map up the strategy as to how to get rid of the waste. So we are here as an embodiment of change. And that is why this time round, we are soliciting your assistance.
Okay, so how...